Are the three credit bureaus being flushed down the toilet? Is the way we calculate our credit scores soon to be obsolete? What do these credit score changes mean for you, the consumer? What's up, guys? This is Mike here. With the new presidential administration, we have a lot of changes coming to the credit reporting industry as we know it. The three credit bureaus may be getting shut down and replaced by a new government program called the Credit Reporting Agency. This could change everything about the way responsible adults go about using credit, applying for credit, and maintaining their credit score. But before we get into that, guys, I want to take a second to let you know that the biggest thing not affecting your credit score is to smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm. Also, guys, just a tip for investors out there, if you want to start investing and don't want to go into a big brokerage firm, or really have no idea what to do when it comes to investing, I recommend signing up for a Webull account. Link down below. It's an awesome app to start your investing journey, and if you invest just $100, they will give you 2 free stocks to get going. This is a great place to learn about stocks, engage with like-minded investors in a community on their forums, so get started today. So what is our current system really like, and how is your score calculated? All three credit bureaus use various methods when reporting your score. Like all companies out there, these companies are prone to making mistakes that can cost you, the consumer. And let me tell you, these mistakes usually affect you for the worse, not for the better. One thing all three have in common is that they use the same metrics to calculate a score for each consumer that applies for or uses credit. Understanding each of these 5 areas is critical in learning how to play the credit game. The better you know these rules, the better your score will be. At the same time, not understanding these metrics and making the wrong moves can severely impact your credit score and your life. The first of these is your payment history. This makes up 35% of your credit score. This record shows whether you make timely payments on your credit accounts or not. The second metric is credit utilization. This makes up 30% of your credit score. This metric simply measures the amount of credit you use to the amount of credit that you have. For example, if you have a $1,000 credit line, to maintain a 30% utilization rate, you would not want to charge or maintain a balance of $300 or higher at any one time on that card. The lower the percentage used, the better for this one. Next one is length of credit history. This simply measures how long you've had credit and how old your accounts are. This accounts for 15% of your credit score. The next metric, guys, is type of accounts. This could mean things like credit cards or an auto loan or a mortgage. Those types of things are calculated here, and this represents 10% of your score. Lastly, guys, is application history. What this is looking for is how many times you've applied for various forms of credit within the past 2 years. Hard credit inquiries and the frequency of which they were put on your credit is what is measured here. And this represents roughly 10% of your credit score, which rounds out the 100% total of the pie. These calculations are very important, guys. I don't want to downplay this whatsoever. They determine the type of car you'll drive, to the apartment that you'll rent, to the mortgage that you'll apply for to buy your dream home. But using these metrics to determine consumers' credit scores does not come without its fair share of flaws and problems. In fact, our current credit industry has many contradictions if you look at it closely. First, you have 3 private companies that are known as the credit reporting agencies. They are Experian, Equifax, and TransUnion. These are privately held corporations for profit that operate independently of each other and gather data on you, the American consumer, and use a secret algorithm to determine what type of credit score you will have and to predict the likelihood that you will repay your loans. For example, they reward you for taking on different types of debt, like car loans, mortgages, credit cards, because lenders can see that you're responsible for handling multiple lines of credit, which is deemed as good. But having too much debt and too many lines is considered bad. Another contradiction is you have to open up a lot of credit lines to establish credit history and payment history. Once you establish credit and payment history, those things are deemed as good. Without account history, you will have a low credit score, which is bad. However, you will be penalized for having too many open lines of credit, and that's also deemed as bad. You're rewarded for having higher credit limits, which means you can take on more debt, which is good. But having too much debt brands you as a high-risk borrower to lenders, which is bad. If you're a renter out there and you make on-time payments, this does nothing at all to help your credit profile and boost your credit score. However, on the flip side, if you ever have an eviction or late payments on your rent, these items will be sure to go on your credit report and negatively impact your credit score for years to come, making it difficult to find a place to rent. So what does all this mean? You would have to rent versus own, as this would be your only option. And thus the cycle continues. Another major problem that this new agency hopes to correct is how difficult it is to fix errors and inaccuracies on your credit report. According to the FTC, 20% or more of all Americans have errors or inaccuracies reported on their credit report every year. If those people don't try to fix those things, just imagine how many errors pile up, which lowers your credit score. Furthermore, this makes obtaining new lines of credit harder to get, and if you do get them, you'll be paying much higher interest rates to have those loans in your name. Another reason that the current system is flawed is that it leaves a sizable portion of the population deemed as credit invisible. An estimated 20% of Americans fall under this category because they've never had credit before, which is mostly young people. The current system simply excludes younger people because they have not been around long enough to establish any debt or credit history, thus leaving young people with lower credit scores paying higher interest rates. So now, a Washington, D.C. think tank has proposed a 110-page plan that would do away with the current system of the three credit bureaus and usher in a new agency that would handle consumer credit reporting. This new agency would be under the direct supervision of the CFPB, which is the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, which would replace TransUnion, Experian, and Equifax as a nonprofit governmental entity. The goal, they say, is to provide better data security, more transparency in how they calculate credit scores, and a much easier way for consumers to solve and fix their credit inaccuracies and errors on their credit report. Other proposed ideas are to cap the interest rate at 36% and to discharge student loans in bankruptcy. What? And even student loan debt forgiveness isn't off the table. Furthermore, the new plan would propose a complete overhaul of the debt collection practice industry. Other new changes would be to calculate bank accounts and rental payments, as well as utility payments, to account for credit report figures. Another major change that will help consumers in this new plan is that negative credit reporting information that typically would stay in your credit report for up to 7 years will now be federally mandated to come off within just 4 years. Under this new plan, a lender would now have to get permission from the consumer in order to run a credit inquiry. Under the current system, those with better credit scores get better lending terms and bigger lines of credit, which helps them save money and grow wealth over the long term. Conversely, those with less attainable credit have higher interest rates, are not able to save money, and thus never acquire or build wealth over the long term. One way of obtaining this wealth is through home ownership. But if your rental payments don't count and you have a low credit score and no money's in the bank, you can't get a loan to even get a home to build equity and have a chance at home ownership and wealth. According to the think tank that is proposing this new plan under the new administration, the current system has failed Americans at accurate credit reporting and unbiased lending practices. The basis for this massive change is to end discrimination in employment, lending, and housing. However, enacting these policies in a short period of time is an unlikely scenario. The wheels in Washington move very slowly. This is very much an uphill battle. It's also not clear how much of a priority this would be for the current administration to push through. And guys, what new government program would be complete without putting politics in the mix? The success of this new program will heavily rely on the person appointed to be the head of the CFPB, which is yet to be determined. Ira Reingold, the executive director of the National Association of Consumer Advocates, has said that with the rising use of alternative data collection, there still exists a level of discrimination that would perpetuate existing inequalities when looking at a borrower. He doesn't see the existing time frame of 7 years as suitable for phasing out our current three credit bureau system and enacting a public one, particularly if this has to be passed through Congress. However, if this agency is set up through an administrative process without congressional approval, it would be a faster process. The point being here, guys, is that the wheels in Washington move very slowly. And this would take, there's still a ton of work to get done. The moral of the story, if you have good credit, keep operating as if the system won't change and do what you've done to maintain that good credit. Conversely, if you have bad credit, make your payments on time, clear up your debt, open up new lines, and never be late. Well, that's it for this video, guys. If you got some true value out of this one, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button for me. And if you don't mind obliterating that like button, it really helps out my video get picked up by the YouTube algorithm. Thank you so much. And I'll be making more videos coming soon on finance and business and real estate. So stay tuned and I'll see you soon.